So I'm Loren Davis. I'm a professor of anthropology at Oregon State University, and I direct the archaeological excavations here at the Cooper's Ferry site in western Idaho.
I'm David Sisson, and I'm the Coeur d'Alene District Archaeologist stationed in the Cottonwood Field Office. So my district ranges from McCall up to the Canadian border.
Hi, I'm Sarah. I began this project in 2012 as an undergraduate student. I took this field school and camped out here for 8 weeks. And after that summer, I was invited back to work as a staff member and have been here since 2012. So this is my seventh summer working here at the site.
My name is Amanda Carroll. I was a graduate student in the past. I've recently defended my master's in the spring of 2018. And so I've been working at the site for 3 years. This is my third year. And I was really lucky to be able to work on my thesis on the site.
And I actually began not working in this area, but working in another area of the site that we closed last year. I got to expose a wolverine mandible and wolverine ribs, and it was a pretty unique opportunity that I was part of. And since then, as a staff member, I learned a lot of opportunities involving supervising and being able to teach other people what I kind of learned my first year here. And I hope to be able to work on projects like this again and work with the federal government or the state government, kind of working on projects to record the history of people living in the Americas. We camp just around the corner. We kind of create this little group at our camp that we're stuck with each other, so it's always fun to get to know people and you really see who people truly are because we're living with them in a really close space.
So what I'm holding here is what archaeologists call a uniface, and so this is basically a flake that came off of making stone tools.
So this is some of the bone fragments that we find here at the Cooper's Ferry site. This is a mussel shell. So mussel shell, as well as bone, can be great tools for us, at least, to be able to date and get an age on what we're finding.
So this is a fragment of a projectile point. So this one came from one of our layers that maybe dates to 11,000 calendar years ago. Whenever we find an artifact, we like to indicate the site that we're at, which is 10 IH-73. Which basically indicates the state, the county that we're in, Idaho County, and then the site number 73. And we work in different units, so 2 by 2 meter squares in the ground, and we work within those squares in quadrants, 1 by 1 meter quadrants.
We give public tours here. It's not every day that people can come to an archaeology site and get a full-on tour. The Cooper's Ferry site has just been so abundant in information about the people living here in the Lower Salmon River Canyon and solving problems thousands of years ago.
The Cooper's Ferry Archaeological Site is located about 20 air miles south of Cottonwood, and we're along a road that would have been actually Highway 95 at one point. The Salmon River Canyon also provides habitat for winter, habitat for deer and elk, and habitat for many other bird species and some really great resources people aren't really aware of. For management of sites, all we see is the surface. We just see the tip of the iceberg. Maybe we see 10% of what's really in the site. And these excavations have opened it up. They tell us what kind of artifacts, what kind of layers are they found in, what do those layers look like, what's the geochemistry of those layers.
As a student, I learned about this site as a way of just sort of understanding the early archaeological record of the Pacific Northwest. So the work that I've done here began in 1997, but then from 2009 to today, we've worked in conjunction with the Bureau of Land Management to run a repeated archaeological field project where we not only do research, we contribute information that helps the Bureau of Land Management with their management goals, and we also offer educational opportunities to OSU students. One of the most rewarding aspects of working at the Cooper's Ferry site, I think, is not only doing the excavation to get the scientific knowledge, but being able to pass that knowledge on to students and also to the public. There are lots of resources on public land, archaeological materials, cultural resources are one of them, and we try to do a good job of communicating to people the value of cultural resources. Well, as we're wrapping up our 10th year working here at the site, we have to start thinking about shifting away from the excavation part to the analysis of all the thousands and thousands of items that we've recovered and pass that knowledge along not only to our partners, the Bureau of Land Management and the Nez Perce tribe, but also to the public.
I'm going to miss just this really nice, detailed, and very efficient archaeology, the wholeness of Cooper's Ferry, the whole process. It's just so unique and so much fun.